Germany and Japan had a devastating effect of World War II. For Japan, in fact, they had wiped out, they had two cities that were wiped out. Pakistan came into being in 1947, but it did not have that devastating effect. Yes, there were massacres, there were mishappenings, but it wasn't war, big scale war. And even then, we are still developing, while the Germany, France, not too much developed. In fact, the Germany is one of the biggest economies in the world. And so is the France. And Japan's technologically advanced. So I'd like to ask you people a question. What is really a problem of our country? Why we are not developed?
Corruption.
Corruption, okay.
Missing of discipline. Missing of discipline.
Discipline.
We don't take ownership.
Ownership, anything? Okay. Actually, these are not the problems, what I see. These are basically symptoms of a chronic illness that we have. Our society is generally suffering from. It's a tragedy of a human being that we generally identify the symptoms and try to suppress it rather than go for its chronic disease. Actually, Pakistan never had a problem. Its main problem is the knowledge and education and its implementation. We generally don't implement our knowledge or education in our lives. I would like to quote one hadith prayer by Nabi Kareem. He said that a person will not be allowed to move away until he answers five questions. And among them, one question is, out of the knowledge and education you have gained, how much you have implemented it? It's very important that we implement our knowledge and education. Our teachers and whoever we meet do not tell us about that. They can't. Because this is the thing that is provided by mentors, basically. Because mentors are people who gives you vision, understanding, and gives you the purpose of life. I give you seven characteristics of a mentor. And you just try to compare it with people you came across in your life. And you will find that we are in real low supply of mentors. What are those characteristics? Let's talk about. One, important. The mentors, you can talk about anything, about your personal life, with the belief that he will be giving you the best of his advice out of his knowledge. Two, whenever you meet him, your perception towards the things, your perception towards fame or maybe perception towards position, everything changes and you start thinking larger than yourself, larger than everything else. Number three, you want to be around your mentor because that gives you that energy, that vibe. Number four, he is down to earth, he is always humble and you don't want fame. Five, he is trustworthy. Number six. He is honest. He always be around you. He gives you the best of his advice. So if you compare these traits with whoever you met across, whoever you have came across in your life, you will find that you did not find so much people. So we need mentors in our life. So I would say that if you want to change our country, if you want to change our society, that it cannot be changed through building institutions. Because institutions don't build people. Basically, it's mentors who build people.